Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Kneon. I am here with Geeky Sparkles.
Hello.
And according to Kurt Russell, you should keep your damn mouth shut.
Well, I don't disagree completely.
Keep your damn mouth shut if you're an actor. But that's not going over very well. That used to be kind of common sense if you were a celebrity or you were, you know, represented a business or something, that for the most part, common sense was to keep your mouth shut and do your job. But now, even if you're like, hey guys, can we pull back on the politics? You're immediately attacked for it. And Kurt Russell is finding himself attacked.
He's going to be especially attacked because he's a straight white old guy.
Yeah, so he's going to be double
canceled. Shut up, boomer.
Shut up, boomer. He legitimately is a boomer, though.
So. I know.
So it's actually, you know, people always tell like Gen X to shut up or older millennials to shut up. This guy actually is a boomer.
Right,
so.
Right. That's my point.
Have at it. Anyway, Kurt Russell, actors shouldn't talk about politics. Before we get into it, please subscribe to Clownfish TV for more pop culture news, views, and rants. We're over 150,000 subs. Thank you for the support. We do have opinions. That's what we do here.
But we're not supposed to talk about politics. Well, we don't actually. We try not to too much.
We talk about people not wanting to talk about politics and getting dragged into talking
about
politics.
Yeah, anyway. Pop culture, which as anymore is synonymous with politics.
So he's out there promoting his new Netflix movie. He's doing another Christmas movie for Netflix.
The other one was pretty good, though.
It actually wasn't bad.
It wasn't bad.
And he said that Kurt Russell says Hollywood and politics don't mix and that actors should step away from saying anything political. He said, I've always been someone who felt we are just court jesters. That's what we do. The Furious Seven star said in an interview with the New York Times. As far as I'm concerned, you should step away from saying anything so that you can still be seen by the audience as any character, added Russell.
How dare he make sense?
How dare he?
Cancel him quickly.
The performer promoting his new Netflix film, The Christmas Chronicles, alongside Goldie Hawn, conceded that there's no reason entertainers can't learn just as much as anybody else about a subject, whatever it is. But I think that what's sad about it is they lose their status as a court jester. I'm just a court jester. That's what I was born to do. Hahn pointed out in the joint interview a famed example of an actor turned commander-in-chief. So Goldie Hawn says, I'm just saying Reagan definitely was a well-known actor, she told the Times. I think it's a personal choice, whether you want to get into that. So that's, she said the one thing she doesn't agree with is just because we have a platform doesn't mean we have to use it. That is our choice.
Yes, that's what I agree with right there. Because I am so tired of actors or anybody, YouTube celebrities, anybody having a platform. They're basically being told, well, you should use your celebrity to help blah, 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 blah. They don't have to use your celebrity to help anything. And oftentimes, if you start doing that, it can actually hurt you in the long run. And it's a load of shit. No one owes you their platform.
And that's what this is all about. And I talked about that earlier on the Animal Crossing video, because, Biden's campaign was basically like, you know, Animal Crossing is a big platform. That's why we made a Biden Island. Mm-hmm. And political activists on both sides of the aisle, any political activist, they look for the biggest megaphone, you know, mm-hmm. and Hollywood actors are pressured into, you know, talking about politics, even if they don't know what the fuck they're talking about.
Well, as soon as you say, yeah, that's it. They get up there and they make a big speech, you know, and sometimes it's like really tone deaf. And that's why they were called out before and stuff. And then you have these people that, you know, that's what they think that they're there for. Now that I'm a celebrity, I'm going to use my platform to speak out on this and that, which they have the choice to do. I don't think it's a good idea. They have that choice. But what happens is everybody like on Twitter and all these places think that every celebrity owes them their platform to speak out like what they want. And that if they don't, they're going to be canceled. And if they don't vote the way they want or have the same opinions the way they want, then they have to be canceled. So it's a very dangerous thing. You're better just to stay out of it and not be, you know, leveraged by these people and canceled for doing, you know, literally doing nothing wrong.
Well, then you start that. Now the difference is back in the day, you could remain mostly apolitical. We always had, you know, political stars, you know, I'm thinking back to, you know, Barbara Streisand.
Oh God, how many times has she said she was going to leave the country and hasn't yet done it?
Yeah, so, I mean, we've always had political activists working in Hollywood or celebrities that, you know, fancy themselves as activists. The difference is now you're not allowed to be neutral. Mark Wahlberg even said in 2016 that a lot of celebrities get political. They did, they do, and they shouldn't. And, you know, but they will actually make a list of the people that are not on quote unquote their side. You know, Twitter activists are making lists of celebrities that need to be canceled because they're neutral. Look at what happened. I mean, how crazy it gets. Look at what happened with Zach Levi. Mm-hmm. Zach Levi says, hey, you know, let's just all try to get along and whatever. And that, no, that didn't work.
Oh, but meanwhile, we were at the store the other day and there's a magazine cover and it was Biden and Harris talking about how America should pull together and get along. Are you going to cancel them now too? How very dare they?
Yeah.
Because, you know, that when it comes from them, it's reasonable and makes sense. When it comes from somebody else, even who voted the way you want them to vote, then it's bad because, you know, how dare they?
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm just tired of it. He's not wrong. He's not wrong. You know, most of the time I'm sitting here like, I really don't care what this actor's politics are. I just want to see a good movie with good characters and I want them to do their damn job. I mean, I don't know why Hollywood keeps thinking that for some reason they're so up their own asses. They keep thinking they're so self-important that everybody's just waiting for their opinion. That's why when the blue checks got banned on Twitter by accident that time, people were celebrating. They were having a party because, oh my God, the blue checks aren't here to preach at us. Woohoo!
Yeah, I know, right? And that's the problem. The problem is that I think the Twitter outrage mob that puts pressure on celebrities, keeps running tabs of celebrities that should say the things they want them to say. And same with companies. We saw it over the summer with BLM that they literally had lists like, oh, this company didn't give their message yet, so we need to harass them until they do.
Right, and it's not okay.
Even if it had nothing to do with, you know, it's like, what does my energy drink have to do with?
Nothing.
Right.
And you want to keep as many people interested in you as an actor or as some of the platform as possible. And if you feel so strong about it, that's what you want to do, that's up to you. You are more than allowed to go leverage your platform for whatever you want it to be, understanding that by doing so, you might be limiting your audience. But the idea that I don't want to take a political side, I want to stay neutral, I want to keep my audience where it is because it's not my job to tell you how to vote. It's not my job to tell you how to think. I have my personal opinions, but they're not your opinions. It's not my job to tell them to you. That is a bad thing, supposedly, even though that's what they should be doing.
So there are some tweets out here bounding in the comics, gathered up some of the reactions, because you know there are going to be reactions.
Oh, God, always.
To this. Now I kind of want to go see his. The first one was actually pretty good.
Yeah, I'll watch it.
It was pretty good. So the Hollywood Reporter put this out, and of course we've got, you know, Kurt Russell saying this can only hurt his career. We got 250,000 dead Americans.
Oh, my God.
Rising.
Like, you know, this is an unprecedented situation. No, you know, people are just doing the best they could do. And I'm not saying everything Trump did was right, but everything he did wasn't wrong either.
Well, that's the thing. And actors should be, and again, say the same with video games, whatever. The world is a shithole right now. They should be making us laugh because God knows we need
to. Allowed to. You can only have politics shoved into everything now because Twitter says so.
I take Obi-Wan's position on politics. I don't trust any politician.
Yeah, I'm pretty much that way too.
You know,
ultimately, they all work for the same people anyway.
They do. It's like two sides of the same coin.
Exactly.
So here we got another blue check who says Rebecca Metz. Silence in the face of cruelty and injustice speaks volumes.
Oh my God. I'm so tired of this too. Meanwhile, I want to point out that some of the people in there that are in extremes on both sides, and including the left, go around and harass people. They're the most intolerant, bigoted people I've ever seen on the both extremes. And you know what? No one's calling their shit out. Silence, I guess, calling your shit out about your bigotry shouldn't be tolerated.
I get comments like this on our videos. We're not stupid. We know you're human. And if I'm going to invest my money, time, and energy in adoring your work, I need to know where you stand as a human.
No, you don't.
No, you don't. Not really. That's the least brave thing I've heard this year. He just made all the characters he played weaker.
Oh, my God.
Good job, Wrinkly Toolbox. Wrinkly Toolbox from Ryan A. Bell Blue Check.
Well, at the end of the day, he's making a shit ton of money and doing movies, and no one knows who the hell you are, so...
God. Well, according to Bounding in the Comics, he's been consistent. Even back in 2015, he said, I'm just selling the movie. I never go out there to do publicity about anything other than the movie. I have my political point of view, of course. I'm an American, and I'm entitled
to
it. You're right. But I don't like espousing it publicly.
Because he comes from the old school, same as, you know, old school people like that, you know, you understand that people vote differently than you. And they always say, don't talk religion and politics. And there's a reason why they say it. And people, you know, think differently than you, but they used to understand that and people still could get along. It didn't affect you getting jobs because he'll think differently than you. And, you know, and we're nowhere near as old as Kurt Russell, but, when we grew up, it was the same thing. People might think differently than you, but you respect that they think differently than you, and you agree to disagree and move on. It's only been this new group of people, and in the last few years, that you have to agree with everything we say. We're not, I can't hear you anymore. canceled. It's like, well, go change your Pampers and then, you know, then give me a call.
Yeah. I mean, look, I wish more. I get it. I get if you're passionate about certain causes. And there are celebrities out there that push certain causes or whatever that I don't really agree with. But it doesn't. I guess my thing is, like, it depends on how they do it. If they're not in your face and calling you terrible if you don't agree with them.
That's just it. It's this whole idea that if, you know, that they're going to bully you into agreeing. And that's where it becomes a problem. They become everything they say they hate to try to push their opinion.
Yeah, I mean, I'm thinking like Joaquin Phoenix. Joaquin Phoenix is animal rights activist and he's, he's a vegan. But he did an interview one time and the guy sitting next to him like ordered a burger. And he's like, you're allowed to. He's like, I'm not going to tell you what to do. But he said, this means a lot to me, but I'm not going to tell you what to do. Let's just talk
about it. Right, because that's how, you know, adults behave.
Yeah.
You know, or the adults, you know, until like the ones that are like mid-20s and younger behave. It's this whole idea that, you know, everybody has to change everything about everything to appeal to me. But the thing is, when you only look at how what you feel and what you think and who you are and what matters to you, then nothing anybody else is going to do. There's always be somebody that's going to piss you off because it's never everything that you agree with and that you want.
Oh, yeah.
Because the only one that's going to meet everything that you want is yourself. So stop projecting and stop putting your beliefs onto everyone else. Because you're one breath, you're like, I believe people have the right to choose this or that or anything else. But then you're telling everybody else they don't have a right to choose that unless they choose what you want. You can't have it both ways.
Stick to sports.
You know?
So they stick to acting. I wish more people would do this, especially now.
You're blessed to get to do that job. Yeah. You know?
Yeah. I mean, you're as a studio owner or whatever, too, it'd be like you're going to risk pissing off half the country by picking either side. So just entertain people, take their mind off of all the shit going on in the world right now, and just do your job.
Right.
Do your job. All right. We're going to wrap it up?
Yep.
Okay. Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants. We'll talk to you guys later.
Bye.